should I pay off my home? So, though there's no simple answer, this video is going to go through the different factors that you need to think through before you work hard to pay off your mortgage loan early. When you try to be debt-free early in your life, it's not necessarily in your best interest. So, I suggest that one of the things you can think about doing is trying to accumulate whatever assets you need to provide for yourself long-term before you start trying to be debt-free. So, for example, if you think that 5 paid off rental houses would provide for your monthly cash flow needs, well then don't be paying down debt early until you've accumulated or purchased 5 rental properties. Or if you need $2 million in retirement accounts or, you know, other investments to accomplish the same thing, focus on getting the assets that you need first. So if paying interest on your loan sort of makes you feel like you're wasting money, think about this example. If your mortgage interest rate is 4% and all of the interest expense on that loan is tax deductible, the true cost to you is more like 3%. So now, where could you make more than 3% on your money, like in an investment? Well, the truth is you could do that probably anywhere. So with that perspective, you're basically wasting money by paying down the debt early when you could make a lot more money somewhere else. And that gets even better. Most people don't realize that a mortgage loan is a simple interest loan, which means that you're paying less and less interest over time as it goes on. Whereas investments are compounding, right? Compounding means you're earning interest on a greater and greater sum every single year. So the way that the numbers work out is that you would probably only need to make about 2% in a compounding investment to end up with the same amount of money that you would have saved from paying off your 4% mortgage. So for those reasons, you know, it's not necessarily a great idea to pay down your debt early. Do you know that trial lawyers can look up in the public records to see if there's a lien on your house, to see how much that they and their client could benefit from suing you? So a large mortgage on a house would be a deterrent to getting sued because people would have to think twice about how much they can benefit from dragging you into court. So do you think that your home equity is safe if you're sued? Guess again. According to current laws, only $40,000 of your equity is safe. Everything else is at risk. So what if in the future you lose your job or suddenly need money? Even if you've paid down your mortgage principal aggressively, the bank will not send that money back to you. So the hardest time to get money is when you actually need it. So if you've lost your job and your income's gone down, you might not qualify for a refinance. So don't just assume you can do that. Or in the last recession, lending tightened up so much, they weren't really allowing people to get money out. So for many reasons, it's not a great idea to just pay down that mortgage. It becomes very financially risky for you the entire time that you're paying it down. So if you were a bank, which house would you foreclose on first? The one with very minimal owner equity and a large loan, so there's not much to cover the bank's loan and fees? Or would you foreclose on the house that's got a lot of equity where the owner's paid it way down and it would easily make the bank whole? Well, every day of the week, they're gonna foreclose on the house with a lot more equity first. So in conclusion, if you really wanna pay off your home loan in the safest and quickest way possible, don't send extra payments to the bank. Now, this is just my suggestion, but consider putting that money, that extra money that you've got, in a low risk compounding investment. And each month add to it the money you would have paid extra on your principal balance. And as that grows, once it gets to the point where it matches your loan balance, then pay off your mortgage loan all like in one payment, okay? Because you're allowing the power of compounding to work for you. Then once your house is paid off, definitely talk to a real estate attorney so that they can help you shield the title, the ownership of your house. And I would also suggest you call your local insurance agent and purchase umbrella insurance. So those two things could really help protect you with this great accomplishment that you've just had. So if you want to discuss any of these ideas further, or if you know anyone who wants to buy property in Colorado in the next 12 months, please give me a call. Ryan Jahnke, 719-210-5517.